inheritance. This is the class that we have. Now, instead of setting the sides, for example, of the rectangle, one might want to actually create a constructor that sets that. So let's do that. Let's create a constructor where you can set the sides. So we go to the rectangle class, and instead of saying set sides, we'll just have a, so we're going to add a constructor here, public rectangle, and then the sides, right? So double S1, double S2, and what this constructor is going to do is actually going to say this.set sides S1, S2. That is basically a constructor that will set that will set the sides for S1 and S2. So let's compile test shapes and let's test our shapes now. Well, it's not going to compile for one reason, right? It is expecting a constructor with two parameters. It does not have the default constructor, and that's very important because we've written our own constructor. The default constructor is no longer valid. We would have to rewrite it. But let's use this constructor. 10, 2.5. Now we're setting the dimensions. I'm not going to use set sides anymore. Now it should compile, right? It does. Now it should run. And then, oops, it doesn't run. No such method. Error rectangle method int. What happens here is this. When a class is, when you have a child class, when that instantiates, it calls the constructor that you tell it to call on the superclass. So when rectangle instantiates here, okay, when you instantiate rectangle, it's going to call the constructor of shape, right? Now, this public rectangle, this constructor, is never calling the constructor of shape, right? So we're never creating a shape. What happens inside a constructor, when you create a constructor, is that if it is not the default constructor, you have to explicitly call the constructor of shape. So for example, once we construct a rectangle, we can say super, which is the word to refer to a superclass, and this is the default constructor, super open close. Now, this rectangle is actually, this constructor of rectangle is actually calling the constructor in the superclass. So now let's test our shape. Let's compile this. And run. Sorry, yes, the super should be actually the first statement in the constructor, not the second one. We're calling the constructor of shape now. And let's compile our test shapes and run it. Oh, and now we still have a problem, right? So we've fixed the rectangle one. Now the problem comes in square. When square is being called, here it has the default constructor. So it's going to try to call rectangle's default constructor, but that doesn't exist. Rectangle here does not have a default constructor anymore. It just has a double constructor. So we would have to come and fix square as well. So let's do that. Let's fix the square by saying public square. Let's create it with a side. And we can do this. Now we're going to call the constructors, the rectangle's constructor with that side. So one can say super. Now super is referring to the rectangle, not the shape. Rectangle with the first side and the second side. In the case of a square, it's going to be the same side. Now we have square with a constructor that takes in double and calls the super constructor. So when I instantiate a square with a double, it can instantiate the rectangle elements. And the rectangle elements also in themselves instantiate the shape elements, right? By virtue of keeping all the constructors in line. So let's do that. We'll have to change the square to accommodate a double. So it could be 10.0. and I can get rid of this square set side as well. And let's see what happens. Compile and run. And now that we have all of our constructors in line, in chain, it's a chain of constructors. So if I create the subclass, the superclass must maintain, the subclass constructor must call a valid superclass constructor, okay? And so on and so on, and so on and so forth, it chains back up. So I have to keep in mind that all my constructors have to be able to call the superclass constructor at all times for it to work.